Now, ladies and gentlemen, as many of you must be aware, India has a national water policy which was formulated way back in the year 1987. This is to govern the planning and development of water resources and their optimum utilization. However, in the wake of the new challenges, the ministry has formulated the new policy, the new water policy 2012. May I request the Honorable Minister, Shri Harish Rawatji, to kindly now release the new water policy 2012, and would like to request the Honorable Minister to kindly present the first copy to the Honorable President.
Shri Harish Rawat, Minister of Water Resources, Dr. Mihir Shaha, Member of Planning Commission, Dr. S. K. Sarkar, Secretary, Ministry of Water Resources, Sri G. Mohan Kumar, Special Secretary, Ministry of Water Resources, distinguished delegates, participants, ladies and gentlemen, I am delighted to join you for the inauguration of India Water Week 2013. Being organized by the Ministry of Water Resources. It's a privilege to be a part of this august gathering comprising renowned public figures, policymakers, experts, and professionals. The theme for this year, Efficient Water Management, Challenges and Opportunities, holds significance in today's context. The severe drought in some parts of our country, particularly Maharashtra, is a matter of grave concern. The increasing occurrence of droughts and floods in India has underlined the need to find solutions to improve the management of water resources. Ladies and gentlemen, our endowment of water resource is disproportionately low than our population. India is home to 18% of the world population, but possesses only 4% of the renewable water resources. Due to population expansion, increasing urbanization and necessity of high economic growth through rapid industrialization, availability of water resources is conspicuous by competing demands. Per capita availability of water has reduced significantly from 1.1816 cubic meter in 2001 to 1545 cubic meter in 2011, just in one decade. The available water must be managed judiciously to meet the twin burden of population growth and economic development. Conservation, balanced distribution, and reclamation of used water are essential cogs in the wheel of water management. Ladies and gentlemen, the influence of climate change on water system is known to all. Various studies have indicated the adverse impact of climate change on the hydrologic cycle, leading to variations in precipitation. This has often resulted in occurrence of flood in some areas and drought in some other different parts of the country. In the climate change also has the potential to affect groundwater by reducing its level and quality. As part of the National Action Plan on Climate Change, National Water Mission was launched in 2011 with the objective of water conservation, minimization of wastage, and equitable distribution. I urge all stakeholders to work towards its success. Our efforts must be directed at mitigating the regional imbalance in water availability. Equitable allocation of water access across the country would be made possible by inter-basin water transfer. But for that, environmental and socio-economic impact should be studied before such an initiative is envisaged. This study requires urgency with the change of time. The provision of safe drinking water has become a serious development initiative around the world. From 76% in 1990, the proportion of global population with safe drinking water sources has increased to 89% in 2010. The number of people benefited has increased over this period by 2 billion, of which our country accounts more than one-fourth. But there is still a significant portion of humanity who remains denied of access to this very basic necessity. The reach of the poor to safe drinking water can be enhanced by developing mid-market technologies that can deliver affordable water treatment devices. Microfinance institutions can be engaged to acquire devices and encourage shared access to safe drinking water. Many of our rural areas are bereft of basic water infrastructure, requiring women to spend a considerable amount of time and energy in collection of water, thereby depriving them from pursuing income-generating activities. Spreading the network of water infrastructure to all underserved areas would therefore be an exercise in the rural rejuvenation. Ladies and gentlemen, our strategies geared to better management of water resources should seek the active involvement of the community. The conviction of the end user is not only necessary for successful implementation, but should be a development objective in itself. I am hopeful that the India Water Week 2013 would be able to provide meaningful solutions and guide our approach to water management. I also expect the Water Expo 2013 to showcase exciting technological possibilities for sustaining these vital natural resources. Once again, I congratulate the Ministry of Water Resources for taking this timely initiative. I also applaud the other ministries, particularly Agriculture, Environment and Forests, and Drinking Water and Sanitation, for extending their partnership. I wish you all success in conducting this event. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Jai Hind.